We are in Hilchot Pesach, getting ready. We are Dinei Bdikat HaChametz, Taf Lamed Gimel. Says the Shulchan Aruch, Bdikat Tzarich Shetiyeh Leor Haner, Velo Leor Haner Levana. You need to do the checking of the Chametz with the candlelight and not with the moonlight. Okay? Let's see the Mishnah Berurah, Leor Haner, Belel Yudaled. In the night of the 14th, she'az bnei adam mitzuyim abateh, and then when people are in their houses, that's the best time to do the bdikat chametz or aner yefele bdika, and the candle of the light is good for checking in that point. Mashen ken or manihig b'layla, but if you have you doing the candle in the day, so it's not you don't see the light of the candle. Right? There's a you know the statement of the Gemara says it in a few places that Shraga betihar amay mehani. Like, what does it help me if I have like a light of a candle in the noontime? Oh. Yeah. So by the way, I'll give a little musar idea that is related with that. You know that. The days of Mashiach, it says Yamim Shein Bahem Chefetz, days that there's no like desire, there's no desire, there's no will there. So there's different explanations of what does it mean, but the simple understanding is that now when you have like the struggle of the Yetzer Hara, so whenever you're getting over the Yetzer Hara, so it's like there's something special, like psh, wow, you did it, Kol HaKavod, right? Why? Because it's night. So you're like getting over that test is like a candle. So there's a light to the candle. Oh, wow, you can see the light, you know? But in the days of Mashiach, so it's like daytime, right? So someone that will do something, you know, get over his Yetzer Hara, you know what? It's not special. It's like, you don't see, you cannot appreciate the light there because obviously like, you know, how can someone be foolish to go and to make sins? It's like obviously that everybody have to follow Hashem's, right? So it's not. So when someone is doing tshuva now, or people that are not Jewish and they are converting now, so then it means something. But as long as the revelation comes stronger and stronger, so it becomes to be okay. You know, like obviously, like. Everybody wants to be part of the Torah. Everybody wants to take their place in Hashem's kingdom, in Hashem's revelation, right? So then it's like already noontime. So you know, doesn't mean anything the fact that you did something like that. So this is like the idea of the night of the 14th, meaning before the 15th, before the revelation. Yeah, so that's like the last chance of like doing Bikat Chametz, that like to do tshuva, to take out the Yetzer Hara, and it will be significant, it will be good, it will be, you know, meaningful. I might say, halachically, if somebody didn't do it in the 14th, they have to do it in Pesach or after Pesach, whatever, but lechatchila. Anyhow. Says the Mishnah Berurah, tiknu abdika davka ledei or haner, sheledei yachol levdok gam bechurin bosdakim. So with the candlelight, you can look inside of the cracks and the holes. If somebody did the checking in the day of the 13th with the candlelight, you should still check in the night of the 14th, like the sages made the decree. Right, and that's also, you want to open the door? Yeah. That's also for in a case that somebody did the checking any time before that. Shalom Aleichem, thank you very much. Also joining us? Yeah, very good.
I don't know, it's my birthday, I don't know what to do.
That's the best thing you can do in your birthday, to learn Torah.
Yeah, I was gonna meet with a big rabbi, but he hasn't gotten back to me. So.
Well, you're meeting here, Rabbi Israel Meir Hakohen Miradin. You heard about him?
Of course, I have him on my wall.
Okay, so that's there you go. You have an opportunity to meet Rabbi Israel Meir Miradin. It's a big thing. It's a big thing. You know, they say that after like the tzaddik passed away, you can meet him in his books. You learn the Torah of the sages, and you it's like you're meeting them.
Well, my grandfather was born not far from there.
Oh, Hashem. So we're learning about the checking of the chametz, and we say that if somebody didn't do it somebody did check before the 14th night, he should recheck it again. So now people are basically like cleaning their houses already, right, for chametz. So in a way, you can say it's like checking chametz, right? I gave my one of my daughters today to go through like one of the closets to take out everything, like whatever is chametz put aside, whatever is kosher for Pesach put back in. So that's basically like checking for chametz, right? So should I check again the in the night of the 14th? The answer is yes. Why? Because there's a decree. That's what the rabbi says. It's a tekanat chachamim. It's a rabbinical mitzvah.
For Pesach, you still put it aside and don't eat it because you opened it before Pesach or something.
Right. Yolom Aleichem. Yep. Baruch Hashem. So, let's continue a little bit in the Mishnah Berura. Says the Mishnah Berura. Okay. בלילה אור אין ערף אל הבדיקה, ונעזר היטב שלא יכניס חמץ, ואני צריך לחזור ולבדוק. יש פוסקים דבדיעבד יצא בבדיקה ראשונה, אכן אם בדק ליל י"ג לאור הנר שבלילה אור אין ערף אל הבדיקה, ונעזר היטב שלא יכניס חמץ, אין צריך לחזור ולבדוק. כן הסכימו רוב האחרונים, ורוצה להחמיר על עצמו לחזור ולבדוק, על כל פנים לא יברך אז. So, that's something very important, because למעשה, there's many people that they having really hard time, they have like a big house with many closets, and if they'll leave everything for the night of the 14th, so they will have like very hard night. They have to like to go through all of their stuff in one night. People that have a lot of stuff, it's a big task, right? So many people, they want to start to do the checking of the chametz much earlier. Now, so what's the answer of the Mishnah Berura? If you didn't do it in the night with the candle, and you didn't have the intention, you'll have to recheck it afterwards in the night of the 14th. Okay, so if you want to start your checking early and to be exempt from the obligation of recheck it in the night of the 14th, you have to check it in the night with the candle. Okay, so a person that have, we spoke last week about someone that have a hotel or a big house like a castle, whatever it is, but it doesn't have to be so big, you know, like, you know, you have to check wherever it's possible that you're bringing in chametz. You know, today I went to sleep. In my bed, and I found in my bag of biscuits. When you have little children, anywhere you can find chametz. There's no place that it makes sense to bring biscuits to the bed, right? But kids, it's not obviously it makes sense. What's the issue, right? So when you have kids, you have basically to check everywhere that they can reach, because they can push in chametz anywhere. So, you know, people that have a big house, so it becomes to be a big task to do everything in one night. So that's the advice. You can split it to few nights, but it have to be in the night with the candle. Okay? So, since after Purim, like within the 30 days before Pesach, as we're learning, the halachot of Pesach, theoretically, you can have like every night to go through like a certain part of the house. But obviously, you have to make sure that no one is bringing chametz there afterwards.
Some families, they lock up their house and they go away.
Okay, that's you're talking about like the really wealthy families that they can afford themselves to you know, to go to a whole week with vacation. You know, it's not so simple. But it's not. Look, I know that there is people like that. There is families like that, and there's maybe quite a bit of people like that. But We're talking about people that they want to stay in their house for Pesach, and they need. Actually, if you already, or if you already mentioning that,
yeah.
I'll tell you, it's not so simple that those people are exempt from checking their house for chametz. You know, they need to do bdikat chametz because this is the tekanat chamim. Unless they leave their house before Purim, like 30 days before Pesach, they're already leaving the house.
Then there's
a sign that they are exempt from the bdikat chametz, but it's not so simple. The rabbi that was giving me the smicha of the Yoreh De'ah, Rav Sedin, so he was living in Hatzion, and then he left to Beit Vagan, and for a while he still had an apartment here, and so in the beginning he came here to do Pesach here. And then he didn't want to do Pesach here. He wanted to do Pesach there. It was a bigger place. He wanted to have guests, whatever it is. So, but he still needed to come here to do Bdikat Chametz. So I thought to myself, well, if he's doing the Bdikat Chametz here and he's not staying here, so maybe I can use his apartment for my family that wants to come over. So he told me, no. I'm not doing such a Bdikat Chametz to be that it will be like clean for Pesach. I just need, like, I'm just like doing the basic, you know, minimum obligation of Bdikat Chametz, that there's no like Chametz mamash there. But it's not like clean for Pesach.
Nothing that you can actually eat, but not the...
Yeah, so I'm just saying there's different levels of like how, if you, just the obligation of whatever it is, you know, so for people like you say, that they're going to leave the house and they're not going to be in the
you
house for Pesach.
A minimum, yeah.
They have a certain obligation, but obviously it's not, they don't have to be so precise and they don't have to do all the cleaning like they are eating in the house in Pesach. Okay? Mm-hmm. And obviously there's lechatchila, bedieved, ratzui, matzui, whatever it is, but...
What about if, let's say, they sell their chametz on the yidal, so they do the sale, let's say...
To sell the house before the Bdikat Chametz. Yeah? To sell the house before the Bdikat Chametz.
Yeah.
You're right. A person can exempt himself from the halachic obligation of doing Bdikat Chametz. If they are not going to be in the house for Pesach, and they want to sell the whole house before Pesach, so you're right. They can do that. It will be, halachically, it will apply, but they exempt themselves from the obligation of the sages, so they lost the mitzvah. You know, they have a rabbinical mitzvah that they canceled.
Yeah, it's a big mitzvah that you have the opportunity to do that.
Right. So, I wouldn't recommend it. If somebody said that he can't, you know, somebody in the States, he have a house here, he doesn't have anyone that will be able to help him to do, you know, to be his shliach, to clean the house, something like that. You know, it's not possible. So you're right. That will be the only solution, to sell the house from before, and then they don't have the obligation. But that's when they have like another house that they're checking. But if they in that week they're gonna be in a hotel, you know, and they going into the hotel just like, whatever, it's not so simple. You know, if they going, let's say they going to the hotel, let's say now, yeah. They rent it from now. So in the night of the 14th, so they are the owner of this house. They're like renters. A renter have an obligation to check his house that he's renting, you know? So it might be that they will have the obligation of doing the kachametz in their hotel room, whatever it is. Wherever, if they are renting a place and they are the owner for that period of time, time of Bdikat Chametz, right? Right. So they have the obligation of checking that, right? It's not. We're gonna discuss those laws. It's not so simple, you know. When you have, let's say, you have a guest that you designate a room for him, but he's not a renter. He's your guest. So you can go in and out, and like if you have something that you need to take from there, you know, whatever it is.
Yeah,
now where I went for Shabbos with my family, so it was not like we didn't rent the place. They let us stay in one of the places there, one of the houses there. So if somebody would have like need something, you know, they could go in and take it. So we are not the owners of the place. So in a situation like that, so you don't have the obligation of Bdikat Chametz because you're not the owner. You need to to be the owner, even on a like time limited base, but yeah, for that time you are the owner, so you have the obligation of Bdikat Chametz. Yeah. Okay. So let's go back to the Shulchan Aruch. Shulchan Aruch says, אם עבר ולא בדק בליל י' ד', כשבודק ביום י' ד', לא יבדוק לאור החמה, אלא לאור הנר. So if you didn't check in the night of the 14th, when you're checking in the day of the 14th, even though it's in the day, you still need to do it with a candle. You cannot do it just with the sunlight. Okay? ואחסדרה שעוררה ומדקה לאור החמה עד היום. Okay, אחסדרה is like a place with, like, you know, when they have like a whole wall that is like glass or like open. It's like a veranda, no?
Oh,
veranda is, will be the right translation for that.
If you have
like a room that a whole side, a whole like wall is like open.
Okay.
It's not like a window. It's like open. I think it's like a veranda. They call it, no?
I thought it's called a
balcony.
A villain.
Villain? I don't know. I have no idea. Anyhow, when a situation like that, so then you have like enough sunlight that comes in, like if you have like a whole, you know, whole side of the house that is open, then the sunlight is enough. Because that's a lot of sunlight, obviously.
The villon, like a small villa, like a villa is like a whole village, whatever. A villon is like a small
version. Villon in Hebrew or in English?
Yeah. No, I mean, it's probably borrowed from English, but they use it in Hebrew.
Villon is like a curtain.
Yeah.
Okay, let's you know, we need to make another class for dictionary. Yeah.
Yeah. Masculine.
Dicky Duke. Anyhow, so Uadin keneged aruba. The same thing is when you have like something in front of. It says aruba. Aruba literally is chimney, but here we're not talking about chimney. We're talking about like a window. So if you have like a window that is open, and you're checking wherever the sunlight is direct on it, so that will be enough. You have enough sunlight coming in. But if you try to check in places that there's shadow, so you have a light comes into the room, but you're not checking in that place where the sun is lighting, so then you have to check it again with the candle. Okay? It's not enough. Let's see the Mishnah Berurah. Rima Vara, אבל לכתחילה אסור לדחות הבדיקה על יום י' ד'. So, again, the mitzvah of checking the chametz in the 14th night is rabbinical mitzvah. If somebody didn't do it, so then you have to check it afterwards. You're right, but לכתחילה, everybody have to do the checking in the 14th. גימל, לאור הנר, שעל ידה יוכל לחפש היטב המחברות וחוברים מצדקים. So with the candlelight, you can check in all the hidden places, cracks and holes and stuff. So, למעשה, today, people are not comfortable to check with the candle, right? We spoke about it. So, there's many people that are starting to checking with the candle, for the mitzvah, but then they do it with the flashlight. A flashlight is much more sufficient. It's like much easier.
Are you allowed to stay in the home of somebody who doesn't check properly for Pesach during Pesach?
It's not a prohibition, but it's not recommended. It's not a prohibition, but it's not recommended. I wouldn't recommend it. Anyhow, Mishnah Berurah Daled, Achsadra. Umakom Shiyeshala Shalot Tfinot Vekirui. Ve'orah Rav Al Yedei Dofen Revi'it Sheptucha Legamrei. So that's the description that I gave you. When you have a room that you have a whole wall that is open, that's called Achsadra. I'm not sure how you call it in English. Hey, Im Badka Le'or Chama. Gam Zeh Meiri Kshavar Ve'lo Badak Lel Yud Daled. U'Bodek Bayom Yud Daled. אחסדר שעורר רב, אין צריך לנר ודאי באורך חמה. מה שגדר ולשון דיאבד, משום דרך התחילה גם באחסדר צריך לבדוק כלל י' ד'. So the Mishnah Berurah is basically saying, it's a question of like, what's the reality? What's the case? If you have enough light, so you have enough light. If when you light a candle in that room, so the light of the candle is not significant, so then you don't need the candle, right? You need the candle when the candle makes a difference. But if you have enough light coming in from the sun, the window is big enough. You don't have to check if like it's the whole wall or you have like a certain like place that there's a wall. It's not about that. Like what's the reality? You know, if you're standing in that room in the middle of the day, you don't need a candle, and you're checking in the middle of the day, so fine. So you don't need a candle. And that's a big like question about today, our generation, when you have like electricity. So if you open all the electricity and the candle in the night is not significant anymore, so it might be the same thing, you know. So like I said, for me in the beginning of the checking, I'm doing it in the night. Like I'm closing, obviously everybody doing it now, but I'm closing the light to have the benefit of the light of the candle for the beginning, and then afterwards I open the light because it's like it's easier to check when you have like the light on, right? But it's not simple to have like what to do to have the light on or to have the light off. You want to check the best you can. So imagine if you're looking for your wallet, you will open the lights, right? You won't check it with you won't search for your wallet in the middle of the night with a candle, right? So when you're searching for something, you open the lights. Anyhow, going back to the Mishnah Berurah, he says, מה שכתב לשון דיעבד, משום מלכתחילה, גם בהחסרת רצה לבדוק לילי דלי. בארבע שעס, למי שלא בדק בלילה, בודק ביום, בודק בצפר, משום דזריזין מקדימים למצוות, ולא יוכל למקום שיבדוק. So like we said in the about the night, that you're not supposed to eat before you're doing the checking. So if somebody, whatever it is, he didn't feel well, he was crushed in the night and he could not do the checking of the chametz, and he's doing it in the morning, it should be also that he will like wake up, pray, and then do the checking of the chametz, not to wait with it for the noontime, not to eat before, you know, doing it as soon as possible. Dayo, Mishnah Berurah Vav. לעניין, אם מותר לבדוק ליל ביום י"ג להוראה, לכתחילה אסור, אלא צריך להמתין על ליל י"ד. So we shouldn't wait for the day time to check, even though it will be easier to check with the light of the sun. We should do it in the night of the 14th. But if somebody did check it, like with a good light, so then he doesn't have to recheck it again. Okay, so again, we're going into that point of if you want to like be exempt in certain places in the house, that in the night of the 14th you won't have like so much stuff to go through. So according to that Mishnah Berurah, so it doesn't have to be with the candle in a case that you don't need a candle, right? So someone that he has like good lighting in his house. So then he doesn't have to wait for the 14th night. He doesn't have to wait for any night and do it with the candle. He can do it whenever. But to open the lights. So if there is something there, he will definitely see it. And then he's careful not to bring in chametz afterwards. And then basically he's exempt according to this Mishnah Berurah. He doesn't have to recheck it again. Okay, but it's not so simple. דיעבד נראה דיין צריך לבדוק שנית, ומעין במגן אברהם סוף סימן שכתב מכל מקום יחזור ויבדוק על כל פנים חדר אחד בלילה. Okay? So the מגן אברהם, he was sensitive to that point. So like, you know, practically according to that, people will, you know, do the checking of the chametz in like bits and pieces through the 30 days before Pesach. And then the night of the 14th, they won't have to check anymore, anything, right? So again, the mitzvah of the sages will be nullified according to that. So again, Avraham says, at least do one, like leave one room for the night of the 14th to check with the candle to have the obligation of the sages like it was supposed to be. Lechatchila. כנגד ארובה שבחדר, ארבעה מקרימה שארובה מקרימה שבאמצע הגג, והוא הדין נגד חלונו שבכתלים. דווקא נגד ארובה ונגד החלון ממש, ששם אורן רב, מה שאין כן מן הצדים, ששם יש גם כן אור, אין דומה לאכסדרה, אפילו נגד החלון ממש, דווקא כשאין בו זכוכית. אבל כשיש בו זכוכית, דינו כמו מן הצדים. So, few things. First of all, the definition of ארובה, says the משנה ברורה, is like opening in the ceiling. They call it skylight. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so sky, what they call today skylight is called aruba in the Shulchan Aruch. Okay, first of all. Secondly, says the Mishnah Berurah, the same thing is about windows. There's no difference. Now, what as I said before, when you're checking right in front of the window, right in front of the skylight, so then you don't need the candle because you have a lot of light. But in the sides, you do need the candle because you don't have so much light. You're in the shadow, right? If you're in the shadow, you need to do bdikat chametz. You have to walk on yourself. Anyhow, no, seriously, it's the same thing. So whatever we're learning here about bdikat chametz, it's also instructions of how to do tshuva, by the way.
How do what?
Tshuva.
Oh, wow.
Same thing, right?
Yeah, that's why we do.
Telling us how to uproot the yetzer hara.
That's why we're very careful.
The grass is, I think on the gada, I don't know, the difference between chametz and matzah, is the head.
Right.
Head.
Yeah.
So that's what we're getting rid of.
Right, right. So we need to take the head and to make it a hay.
Right.
So the head is the sin and we want to make it a hay, which is like part of Hashem's name.
Right.
Very good. Baruch Hashem. Bezrat Hashem. Anyhow. So yeah. So if the Mishnah Berurah says if you have glass on the window, it's not totally open. So then it's like in the sides. It's not like in front of the window. Even when you are in front of the window, when the window have some kind of a veil, some kind of a screen, even glass, says the Mishnah Berurah, it's like in the side. So then you need a candle. Okay? I'm not sure about the reality of the glass in the days of the Mishnah Berurah. Maybe it was not so clear like we have, because today you have like glasses that you don't see the glass. It's like it looks like it's open, but you have glass, you know. So if it's like that, if it's like open, you don't see anything. So you don't see anything. So you don't need the candle. Simply, halacha. Okay. But anyhow, the Mishnah Berurah. That's what the Mishnah Berurah says. So there is a side for that. I'm sure that there is rabbis that will say no. Even if you have glass that is so clear that you don't see the glass still, because the Mishnah Berurah says it. So you have to light the candle. Fine. Anyhow, one more paragraph. Bet en bodkin leor avukah ela leor aner, velo bener shel chela, velo bener shel shuman, velo bener shel shemen, ela bener shel shava. So the Shulchan Aruch, you don't check with a flame of a torch. Okay? So a torch, it doesn't mean electric torch, obviously, it's like the old torch, which is like big flame. Yeah. So the definition of a torch in Halacha is when you have, for example, the Avdala candle is called avuka. Same term. Yeah. So we have like two wicks that the flame is connected, that becomes to be like avuka. That's the minimum. Yeah. Obviously, it can be bigger, but that's basically the definition.
So a torch is just like two wicks or three wicks.
That's the minimum. It can be like 1,000 wicks or whatever it is. It can be like in the, I'm not sure exactly how they did the old-fashioned kind of torches, but something like that. It's like it's not the candle. It's not, you're not checking with it. So that's the Mishnah Berurah. Why are you not checking with the torch? שאין יכול להכניסו לחורים ולסדקים, ושהוא מתירא שמה ישרוף הבית ולא יוכל לבדוק יפה, ואין בודקים בעצים למשחה שקוראים לשאורן, שאורו גם כן גדול, כן אבוקה. So basically the reason that you cannot check with something with such a big flame is because you will be afraid to put it in your closet, through your stuff, because it might burn everything, right? So the point is that you'll be like too careful not to burn everything, and then you won't check properly. So you can't take something with a candle that is too high. Okay? now then the Mishnah Berurah says, the Shulchan Aruch says, don't take a candle that is made out of chelev, forbidden fat. So So when we were learning in Yoreh Deah about the Halachot Chelev, I told you that in the old times, they used to do like candles with this forbidden fat.
Tallow.
Tallow?
Tallow, I think.
Tallow?
The material that they use.
Tallow. Okay, fine. Says the Mishnah Berurah, what's the reason? Because he's afraid that a drop of that chelev will go on the vessels, on the utensils that he have in the kitchen, or food, or whatever, and then it becomes to be prohibited. Can't use it anymore. So, because he will be too careful because of that possibility, so he won't check well again, right? So the idea is to have something that gives you light, but you can control it. You're not afraid it will burn. You're not afraid that it will drip. Then he says also about the shemen, also about the oil. Don't use a candle that is made out of oil. Why? Says the Mishnah Berurah, Hashem tirei lechnisa lechorin lazdakin, shema yishpech ha-shemen. The same thing, you're afraid that the oil will like drip over, whatever. ובדיעבד, אם בדק לאור האבוקה, אינו חל הבדיקה, וצריך לחזור ולבדוק לאור נר יחידי. של חלב ושל שומן, בדיעבד חל הבדיקה, ושל שמן יש דעות בין האחרונים, אי חל בדיעבד. So, all of that is לכתחילה, but after effect, if he did it, he checked with a big flame, or with like the חלב or oil. So, אבוקה, the flame, the big flame, he have to recheck with the candle. If it is the חלב, or fat, so then b'diavad it's okay, and if it is oil, so there's a discussion. It's not so clear. So what will be the best choice lechatchila? Says the Shulchan Aruch, ner shel she'ava, weak oil, not weak. No. She'ava, wax oil, wax candle. And the Rama is adding vu yechidi, but shnei nerot biyachad afilu kluim dinam kavuka, right? So if you have two candles like we have in or more, 2 weeks is like we have in the Avdala, like I said, so then it's not good. It's like avuka. Says the Mishnah Berurah, ner shel she'ava. If men lo ner shel she'ava, yochol yivdok ba'otan nerot shebediyavad yotzei b'hem. If he doesn't have this candle of wicks of wax, he can check with those other candles to be yotzei b'diyavad. And about the candles that are weaved together, okay.
Kaluim.
Yeah. Rotsu lomar, kol shekenim dibkan biyachad achashiv avuka. How much more so if they are stuck together that they are considered to be like avuka? Ela afilu kluim salga datach dikichad ner dami kamash malan. So you would think that it will count like one candle, but the answer is no, it's not like one candle. Primagadim, mashma de kol shochzon biyado yachad v'enom fridan zemizeh chashiv avuka. According to Primagadim, as long as you're holding them together and you're not separating them, so even though they are not connected, just because of your grip they are connected, so that's enough to be called avuka, and then you're not yotze. Ner sheyesh lo shtei piyot, kama sheosim ata b'ner shel chelev lefayim, sheyesh efresh ben ptila, ptila chashiv avuka. If you have like 2 wicks that are coming out from the same candle, so even though the flames are not connected, still it counts like avukas as the Mishnah Berurah. Okay, we'll hold it here. Bezrat Hashem, tomorrow we will discuss the different places that needs the checking. So be with me. Bezrat Hashem. L'chaim tovim u'l'shalom. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen v'amen.